Hello, hello. My name is Sofia and this is the walkthrough to OSINT Exercise 001. On my website, you can find a number of OSINT exercises to practice your skills. If you haven't attempted to solve this one yet, you can find the link in the description and give it a go first. If you're here because you have completed, well done, you should be very, very proud. If you're here because you want to find out how to solve it, I hope you find this video useful. As this is the first exercise on my list, I want to go through the basics first. Each exercise page will contain some brief text that will explain what is expected of you. You may be presented with one or more questions. At no point you'll ever need to contact or find personal information about anyone, so please behave. Don't ruin this for everybody, okay? There'll always be a link to a file, so you can see this one here, most likely an image of some sort. The exercise level information, this one here, will help you adjust your expectations. If it's marked as hard and you're in beginner level, it's okay if you cannot solve it. I have added the levels based on how long it takes me to solve something at an expert level. If it only took me a few seconds, I mark it as easy. If it took me a few minutes, I mark it as medium. If I start thinking to myself, why and how did I get myself into this, but still manage to solve it, it's probably hard. A quick note on this exercise 001, although I marked it as medium difficulty level for experts there, if you're only used to geolocating in urban areas, this will be hard for you. Don't feel bad if you're an expert and still couldn't do it. I went with this one as the first exercise on my list because it's a good example of a geolocation that looks hard at first, but it's fairly straightforward. It was also the first I did when I had a brilliant idea of creating OSINT exercises and I was too lazy to change the order, so there's that. Whatever. Okay, I'm done with the talking. Let's get this party started. OSINT Exercise 001. Task briefing. Below, you can see a screenshot from a tweet containing a photo. It contains all the relevant information necessary to help you find the exact location. Please identify the coordinates of where the photo was taken. And you can click there for the photo without a Twitter border. And here you go. I have saved it on my computer so I can just zoom in because I really like to zoom around and look at every detail. Back again. So as I've said, exercise level for beginners, this is a hard one. It's very unlikely that you've managed to solve it if you are a beginner. For experts, it's medium. Like I say, it took me a few minutes, like 15 or 20 minutes, but I'm very used to geolocate stuff with satellite image only. So if you're not used to that, it might be hard for you, and that's fine, okay? So this is the tweet. You may notice that I have cropped the top because you do not need to know the information about who posted it. It's not relevant. And again, I don't want to stalking anyone, but you can see that was translated originally from Arabic. So you know you're in a country that speaks Arabic, likely. And I left the translation so you can read. In the morning, the cities display their beauty and present themselves to the newcomers. The beautiful city of Kifa has shown its virtues this morning. So if you're like, oh wow, I already have the city, how hard can it be? Huh? Welcome to geolocation. You can also check out that I've left the date. Dates are important, especially if they're older, because things change all the time. So you always need to know what year at least you're looking at. I have added the note that I did not take the photo, I don't have the rights for it, it was taken by whoever posted this tweet, and it's just educational purposes, right? So it should be fine. Okay, so what can we find out about this photo at first glance? You can see that this is a road that leads to nowhere, apparently. You have some buildings on this side of the road, you have a paved road, and you have some buildings on this side. There's some gap between this building and probably this one as well. There's some gap, but although the angle makes it seem that this is wider, it may or not be. You can see there's a tree, a very tall tree behind this building, and trees are amazing. We're trying to geolocate anything with satellite imagery because they don't often move. Then what you can also see is there seems to be some sort of dip or something. The road seems to go down and up. It could be the angle it was taken, but I have the feeling that it's not straight. It kind of just goes down a bit. There are a lot of trees there. In fact, if you zoom in, you can see, oh, that's too much. This is some palm trees. It's going to be some Central African country or something based on the style that you're looking at. can also see some poles, electrical poles, and that's it. There is not that much to be seen. This has all the information we need to geolocate it. So the first thing we do is obviously we have the name of the city. I mean, how hard can it be? How many kifas are there in this world? Luckily for you, I have chosen one that only has one. There's only one kifa and it's located in Mauritania. So there we go. I'm going to zoom out so you have an idea of whereabouts we are in the world. So there we go, Mauritania, and this is kifa. And they're like, okay, how hard can it be, right? You can just get the pigment and look at street view and welcome to geolocating in the middle of nowhere. There is no street view. That's amazing. Okay, but you can see there's three dots there that indicate that they may have some panoramic photos. Unfortunately, this one doesn't work for some reason. I don't know if you can make it work. I couldn't, whatever. And then we have this one. So you can obviously see this is not the same location, but one of the things you can see, however, is the structure of the buildings is very similar to this one's. So it's very likely we are in the correct location. So similar buildings, and you have a road, and there's a road, and so on. But this is not the correct location, so it's not very helpful. So then you can also check the last one, because we know, look at that, from looking at this, you can see that there is no buildings there. So it's very likely that this is the edge of the town. You know that, it's the edge of the town, there's no buildings there, there's buildings on this side. So maybe that panoramic photo was useful. It is not. It is not useful at all, because it's in the middle of absolutely nowhere. You still have these buildings, similar buildings, you have the paved road, but buried, arid, desert-like ecosystem. So let's go back. So how can we solve this? If you start zooming around, you realize, oh my God, this is very, very dense. How can you find anything on it? And it looks hard, like I said, it looks hard at first, but it is not hard. So what we're going to do now, we're going to jump from Google Maps to Google Earth Pro. Google Earth Pro is free. You can have the web version, you can have the desktop version. I use the desktop version just because I like it. I use it a lot, so why not just have it on my computer? So you right click and then you click on the coordinates. So they have copied to clipboard. So we go to Google Earth Pro and we'll paste them there. So we'll go right to the middle of Kifa, our target city in Mauritania. And here we go. Okay, let's zoom out because obviously that's not the exact location we're looking at. So one thing you can do is click roads. So there's several things you can tick on this side, and there's the option roads. And why we're using the option roads? Because we've established that we're looking at a paved road. And one thing you can see here, if you just zoom a lot, is that most of these roads are not paved, they're dirt roads. You have the paved one there and you don't have the paved ones here. Maybe this one is paved, I'm not sure, whatever. So you can see these are the main paved roads and they lead to outside of the city, and we already know that we're looking for a road that leads outside towards somewhere. We don't know where it leads, doesn't matter now, but we know there's buildings there and there's no buildings there. So our back is turned, if we are a photographer, our back would be turned to the center of the city, right? So what we're looking for, we're looking for a place that could be there. So we have paved road outskirt there, paved road outskirts, maybe there, maybe there, maybe there. So we're looking for outskirts of the city, just a bit. And another thing you may have noticed when we looked at this panoramic image is that there are no trees. They're just nothing. I mean, maybe in a very far distance, but there are no trees and we need trees. They're on the picture, we need them. They're very close. So where are the trees? So if you start looking at that again, there are not many areas outskirts of the town that have a paved road and then they have trees. It's there. We have trees there. Look at that, look at that. These are trees. So let me just unclick that because I'm going to rotate the camera. So we're looking out the city. Like I said, the photographer will have their back turned towards the city and we'll see trees. It may have other buildings after the trees. We have no idea. We cannot see it, but in front of us, we have trees. So just hang on for a second and I'm going to move this window so they're next to each other. We start comparing this location. Okay, I have placed the windows next to each other. So we have our photo from the tweet and we have our probable location. But before we start looking at this location, we have to remember something very important. We are not looking for a recent image. We're looking for an image from 2013. So we have to go back in time. And Google Earth Pro has that option and that's why you're using it. And we're not using Google Maps. So if you click there at the top, you have some sort of clock with an arrow pointing back. And if you move this bar all the way till 2013, it doesn't really matter exactly when. That's probably fine. Let's go back even more. Oh, too much. 2010 is too much. Okay. This is a bit better than the other one. So let's really look at this image. So what can we see here? We can see building. The first time I looked at this area, I immediately knew it was a great one because of the tree. Remember I told you the tree? They are amazing. So what did I look at? I saw a building that was next to the road. It was close to the edge of the city. It had the trees there. It had a paved road and it had a tall tree just behind the building like this one. So this is this road. You can see there's some space there and you have the building on this side as well. And then I'm not sure if you remember that I said that this road seems to have a bit of a dip and goes up again. I feel like this is because it goes over a river. So it's likely that it goes down a bit, up the river, small little bridge, and goes up again across this bit of trees. Another thing we can always see is vertical landmarks. So vertical landmarks are amazing when you're looking at satellite imagery because they cast a shadow. Depending on the angle that the satellite photo was taken, you can see vertical tall structures casting a shadow. So it's likely that we'll be able to see these electrical posts casting shadow. We cannot see it here, but they don't often move, just like trees, isn't it? So if we can move around a bit, oh, there we go, 2017. Look what we see there. Electrical pole. And there you go. You have the electrical poles along the side. You have the tall tree. You have the buildings. You have the buildings, the paved road. You have the building on this side. You have everything. And this is it. This is how I geolocated this picture from Twitter in just a few minutes. It obviously took me longer than on the video because, you know, you have to go through all these steps one by one. But most of it, when you're looking at satellite imagery, you look for very specific details and you start narrowing your searches until you get to a spot and it's just perfect. Everything just lines up perfectly. And that is it. This is how you solve OSINT Exercise 001. I sincerely hope you found it useful and you learned some techniques. And if you have any feedback, please leave it on the comments somewhere. Thank you for listening.